All right, good morning, everybody. I'm Coral Flanagan, and this year I was interning with the Rhode Island Department of Education, also known as RIDE. I want to start by thanking Sarah Whiting and Lauren Matlock for being here today, my supervisors for my internship. So RIDE is responsible for ensuring that every public school student in Rhode Island is prepared for their future. And one of the ways that they do that is by assuring the quality of educator preparation in the state. So these are the program or the providers that provide the programs that prepare a lot of the teachers and administrators who work with Rhode Island students. And there are 11 providers in Rhode Island, 8 are university-based, and 3 are alternative certification pathways. And this was the main focus of my internship. So one of the mechanisms that RIDE uses to hold providers to a high standard is the Performance Review for Educator Preparation process, which is called PrepRI. And during PrepRI, a team of educators and preparation staff conduct a review of a provider using a rubric that has 7 standards. And the rubric covers areas from professional knowledge to program quality. The review process culminates in a report which provides a rating for each program, for each component of the rubric. So for example, for the elementary education program for X University, they may receive a rating of approaching expectations for standard 3.1, which is candidate diversity. However, another important function of the report is that it includes a lot of feedback for providers that's intended to help them as they work towards meeting the standards in the future. And my internship was focused mostly on this continuous improvement function of the PrepRI process. So my essential question for my internship was, how can RIDE more effectively support education preparation programs in their continuous improvement efforts? And I responded to this larger question in 2 separate parts. So first, in order to target the assistance that RIDE provides to providers as they're working towards meeting the standards, it's important to understand where do we actually need to improve. So I did a descriptive analysis of the existing PrepRI reports to find the areas of strength and weakness across all providers. So for example, table 1 shows the aggregated results for all providers for standard 3, which is candidate quality, recruitment, and assessment. And as you can see, for some of these standards, like 3.3 and 3.6, all providers were rated at least approaching expectations. So these are areas of strength across the state where all providers were rated meeting or approaching expectations. But you can see for some other standards, like 3.1, 57% of providers did not meet expectations for candidate diversity. And figure 2 shows the areas across the state where providers have a lot of room to improve. So I use my analysis for research question 1 to inform questions that I use for 4 focus groups that I conducted with education preparation providers. And the purpose of these groups was to understand how providers are currently using the feedback in their reports to improve, to work towards meeting the standards, and also to think about how can we improve the PrepRI process. And I compiled the results of the focus groups into a policy memo. And the memo included recommendations both for policy changes and also a lot of practice changes to improve PrepRI. So I'm going to present just a few of those recommendations today. I'm going to start with this. One key finding of the focus groups was that some providers are unsure how to translate the recommendations they're getting in their reports into plans for improvement. And a lot of providers also said that the sheer volume of feedback they received through this process felt really paralyzing to them at times. So my policy recommendation was to allow providers to choose one area to maximize their improvement efforts. And then they'd be able to be formally recognized in the PrepRI process for being able to improve in this area that they selected. And this change is closely related to a different recommendation I had in my report for a change in practice. So another piece of feedback that came up through the focus groups was that a lot of providers felt they weren't receiving enough formative feedback from RIDE throughout the PrepRI process and as they were creating their plans for improvement towards the standards. And my practice recommendation was for RIDE to offer providers the opportunity to collaborate with them on their improvement plan for one specific area. And so the idea is once they have developed this example, they can use that then as an exemplar for their improvement plans in other areas, understand clearly how to take the feedback they get in their report and transform that into effective improvement towards the standards. A third theme of feedback from the focus groups was that a lot of providers had different concerns about the selection and training of the review team that conducted the review. So common concerns included things like reviewers who weren't familiar with the alternative certification pathways or the racial and ethnic diversity of the review team. And my practice recommendation was to make the reviewer selection process more transparent, perhaps making a document that visually presents how this process works, and then share it with providers during quarterly meetings, which RED conducts with all providers across the state. So that brings us to the final piece of feedback that I want to discuss today. And that's that providers universally appreciated any concrete examples they got from RED of high quality work towards the standards, and they felt like they needed a lot more of that. So my practice recommendation was to provide more examples of work towards the standards and have this come close or soon after they receive their PrepRI report. And this relates to my third strand of work for my internship. So based on my analysis for research question one, I worked with Sarah to choose three standards where a lot of providers have room to improve. And so these three are measuring impact on student learning, selecting and preparing clinical educators, and candidate diversity. And we developed some data snapshots which provide context and resources and examples for providers to use to jumpstart their improvement in these areas. So these pages are from the tool that I created for Standard 3.1, which is increasing candidate diversity. And so one element of all of the snapshots was some data that provided context to show why it's so important for us to have improvement in this area. And these graphs show the mismatch, racial and ethnic mismatch and gender mismatch between teachers and students in Rhode Island. Another part of the snapshots was information about our performance so far towards meeting the standard. So again, you can see 57% of the providers aren't meeting the expectations for candidate diversity. And then the last part, the really important part of the snapshot, is links to examples and resources that providers can use to start making improvements in this area right away. So my recommendation in my policy memo was to build out tools like these for all of the areas where we have a lot of room to improve the weakness areas for providers across the state so that they can get these resources soon after they receive their rating and right away start making a plan to improve in that area. So ultimately my goal for all of this work is that it will contribute to making PrepRI as effective as possible. So in my descriptive analysis, I found there's a lot of areas where we're doing really well in preparing educators in the state, but there's also a lot of really important areas where there's room to improve. And this is a really labor-intensive process, both for RIDE and for providers, and so I'm hoping that my recommendations can contribute to making this process as effective as possible and to helping providers take advantage of all the information they get through this really extensive review process. And then overall, we know from research teachers are one of the biggest factors in affecting outcomes for students. So I'm really hoping that this work can contribute to improving public education for all the students in Rhode Island. In terms of the insight that I gained personally from this work, first I would say a better understanding of the role of a state education agency. So a lot of the work I was doing was about much more about supporting providers and meeting expectations than just in setting policy. And finally, through the two research questions I worked on, I got to see educator preparation from a lot of different perspectives. And I think I got a much better understanding of the context for working towards these standards. So this summer, my practicum team worked with Sarah and Lauren, and we were thinking about educator diversity in the state. And at that time, it was really hard for me to understand why is there this mismatch between RIDE's policies and what's actually happening with providers. But I feel like now, having talked to a lot of providers and looked at this issue from different perspectives, I understand a lot more all the stakeholders who need to work together to make change in this area and some of the barriers or perceived barriers that are making it difficult for us to make progress. So finally, I just want to say thank you so much to Sarah and Lauren for being here today and for all of your support throughout this internship. I learned so much from both of you. I really appreciate your mentorship. And thank you also to Christina for all of your help with all of us as we were choosing our internships and throughout the whole process. So thank you very much.